Hello everybody, happy Star Wars Day to you, happy Friday to you. Wait, it's not Friday today, is it? Happy Monday to you, I'm crazy. And today we are celebrating the excellent Star Wars Day by playing the fantastic TIE Fighter Collector CD-ROM. My name is Flaose, and I will be your host today. Dressed up, just for you, in the Darth Maul costume. This is my first time ever doing something like this. I hope it goes well, and I hope that you all are well. So, let me just pop up chat for a minute. It's disappeared. There we go. Hello, everybody. Nightwolf, Donis the Horror, Ovenale, All24B, Lucian Sinshu, and all the rest. Hacker, Shawfalk, Metal Addict, the G Pudding, Hatnix, Inito Kisio, Got a Gamer, and so many others. And Moobot hates me. Moobot is a jerk. Actually, I haven't had a chance to update Moobot, but we'll see what happens. Captain Judaism, it's a secret. I guess, you know, for a lot of you, it is the 5th right now, so happy return of the 5th. I think it is appropriate that we be playing TIE Fighter right now as well. And to anyone from the Netherlands, also, happy Liberation Day. Thank you so much for still celebrating that day, which is so important to my country, and I know to your country, here, 70 years later. So, thanks. Alright, so let's turn down this music that I'm playing that you probably can't even hear anymore. And you're out of here. And so, thank you, Pyro Jade, so much for setting the Moobot as well. I did not get a chance. So today, guys, we're going to be playing the fantastic TIE Fighter. Came out in 1994, but a CD-ROM Special Edition came out in 1995, and just recently released on GOG.com was this TIE Fighter. So, Revenge of the Fifth, Revenge of the Fifth. Yes, how could I, I'm just so nervous, guys, to be on the stream like this. I tweeted it out with the hashtag, May the 4th be with you. I don't know if anybody else is going to come, but if there's anyone new, welcome. So, without further ado, guys, let's get started, and we will be playing TIE Fighter Special Collector's Edition. A long time ago in a galaxy far, far away. At the Battle of Yavin, rebel terrorists aided by spies and traitors within the Empire struck a cowardly blow at the new symbol of Imperial power, the Death Star. Darth Vader brought swift justice to the rebels by destroying their main base on Hoth, the pitiful remnants of the Alliance, now scattered to the Outer Rim. In the days ahead, the Emperor will call upon the Imperial Navy to eradicate the last vestiges of rebellion and restore law and order to the galaxy. It took me 2 hours to do this, that's why I started a little late. I was surprised how long it took. At last, we shall reveal ourselves to the Jedi at last. We shall have our revenge. Oh, I love this music. Agreed, guys. Agreed. TIE fighters escort shuttles to Coruscant City, where the Emperor is about to speak.
The Empire is on the verge of success. Soon, peace and order will be restored throughout the galaxy. Even now, our capable forces, led by Darth Vader, are striking back at the rebel insurgents.
The rebels are unprepared for our attack. Signal Vice Admiral Thrawn to launch his TIE squadrons immediately.
has no hope of escape. Commence the attack.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Russo. Collector's CD-ROM! Oh, Heimdall plays. She's already seen it. She was moderately terrified. Alright, so that is the intro, guys. And we'll skip this wonderful credits with the beautiful music. We'll center our joystick. Top left. Bottom right, because we gotta always
enter your name,
prepare our joystick. Calibrate it, even. So, I have not started a new profile. I did just get this a few days ago, and I was playing around, but I wanted to start fresh with you guys. So we are ready to restore peace and justice to the galaxy. Flaose, rank flag cadet. Actually, what am I talking about? Today I'm Maul. Score 0, level medium. We'll keep it on medium for now. Hopefully, things go okay. For those of you who are not familiar with TIE Fighter, I feel very sorry for you, but I'll give you a quick rundown. This is the registration, this is where we just came from. There's the training simulator, where you go around in circles, practice with the different crafts. The combat chamber, where you can, it's more in-depth training, and you can also replay past battles if you've already completed some parts of the mission. We have our tech room, which is, I'll actually show you this one quickly. It shows you all the craft in the game, which is pretty cool, and you can rotate the craft like that. Top Ace 10. The Top Ace 10 was meant for those who had bought the disc version of the game. There was an add-on which brought it from, I think, 7 battles to 10 battles, and then, with the CD-ROM edition, there were 3 more battles added. So instead of having, maybe you've lost your save, instead of having to start from the beginning, it was for those who had already played the first battles. Dark Side of Nice Heimdall. So this is the flight room. The film room, where you can watch films, which you record. And where we're gonna go is new battle, and this is where you continue battle up there. So, battle 1, Aftermath of Hoth. Pursue rebels fleeing from Hoth. And you can actually start in battle 1, 2, 3, and 4. But we're gonna actually play the game in order, which is pretty normal, I suppose. And let's get this. So if you've ever played X-Wing, TIE Fighter, X-Wing Alliance, you understand the whole game. You start with a briefing.
New TIE Fighter from Alpha, Beta, and Gamma squadrons will be out on patrol around Outpost D-34. Your mission is to inspect all cargo...
What's up? I'm not game, but money is money. Welcome. Welcome.
We are on the lookout for rebel forces that are fleeing from their base on Hoth. One TIE fighter from
Thanks, Jack.
Beta and
Good to see ya.
Squadrons will be out on patrol around Outpost D-34. Your mission is to inspect...
I haven't even been paying attention to the briefing. Okay, so let's get started. Always Hoth. So here we are. The best part...
Incoming ships. They are entering the area near point B-18.
About this game is that it has both a dynamic soundtrack and speech. In the disc version of the game, you had dynamic soundtrack but no speech. In the future, the 1998 version of this game, you had speech but no dynamic soundtrack with iMuse. So, this is the best of both worlds. This is the version to play. If you're going to play just one, you play this one. So, if you hit the G button, you can look at your goals. We have to inspect all of Freighter Group Onase and also Data. Nightwolf, my favorite craft in this game is probably the Tie Defender, because it has shields, because it has six lasers that you can link together, and it's just devastating. And in other games, when the Tie Defender shows up, you're in big trouble. So guys, if it's too quiet or too loud, just let me know, and I will definitely change that. Of course, in this game, you're flying with a TIE fighter a lot of the time, and the TIE fighter is a weak craft. It has no shields, it's so fragile, so you have to be very careful. It plays very different than the old game. Or, sorry, it plays very, very different than X-Wing. And G-Pudding, you can't play with the mouse. I don't like playing with the mouse so much, but here is me controlling with the mouse right there. When I was young, I didn't have a joystick, so I played with the mouse. Played this game with the mouse. I didn't do so great. I had to cheat my way through. A nice thing about this game, though, if I hit escape, you can actually change if player versus starfighter collisions happen, if you're vulnerable or invulnerable, and if you have limited or unlimited ammo. Playing otherwise, if you put on these cheats, you will get a score hit. A pretty severe score hit, too, especially if you put on invincibility. But...
the incoming shuttles have not identified
themselves. Oh, man. New Rebel shuttles! So I just gotta inspect these guys. There we go.
The first wave of freighters and transports has been inspected.
Oh, I'm still flying. So these guys are actually attacking me. So I need to get myself out of the way. Exactly, Exiled Wizard. So this guy is about to attack me. There are three shuttles. And I need to stay out of his way or I am toast. So now that he's turned, I'll get on his back, hit enter to match his speed, and now I'll take the dude out. Maybe slow down a bit to back off when I'm getting too close. You see my reticule turns green, and that means my shot's lining up. Obviously when it's right in front of me, it's not a hard shot, but you can also lead your target and the reticule will leave for you. Gee pudding, that's impressive. I definitely do not have those kinds of skills. I'm gonna back off. If you're too close when these things explode, sometimes they'll explode right into you and kill you. Oh, okay, so you see the red just turned up on my reticule? That means someone's attacking me. Shuttle row 3, so if I hit the E button, he shows up, my enemy shows up, the nearest attacker, and so I can take this guy out now. And it might be that the other shuttle's gonna attack me, and then I'll just hit the button again and take him out. Playing too much the new games. In the new games, they've added so that... ooh, exploded. They've added it... the wrong button. They change it so that you can't turn at full speed very well. When you turn down the speed, you do better turning radius, or have a better turning radius. But in this game, it's the opposite. You want to be full strength. Oops. So I'm gonna just inspect these freighters if I can, these Corellian transports, I mean. Without getting killed, if possible, because I think the escrow is after me. There we go. So we have completed our mission. We could go home, but I'm going to just take out these shuttles. After that, a whole bunch of rebels come, and it's insane, so I'm not going to be doing that. Also, friendly fire is something you have to watch out for. If you're too close to the back, your buddies might just get too overzealous and kill you. Alright, close. I could kill my own guy if I were not careful enough. Well, so I was just about to finish off that other guy, and I had to give up because this guy started attacking me. There we go. And we'll take out this guy. And then we'll head home. Oh, and they stole my kill. Brutal. So I'm gonna head back to my base. There we go. Get out of here. I wonder if you win the game by defeating the to get the bonus objective so that they're no. Who just destroyed the freighter? I think I don't even know what happened there. The freighter was just heading home, and it just suddenly exploded. That's not supposed to happen. So in this game, there are a whole bunch of bonus objectives. One of them, I think, is when this freighter makes it to hyperspace. And also, you take on a whole bunch of X-Wings that show up in about 10 minutes. It gets pretty crazy. I find that these the throttles don't work so well with these games. So the way I play it is I have... Let me aim the camera down a bit. And over... Well, I have my X-52 over here. I have my X-52 over here, and then my keyboard is what I'm playing with. And yeah, guys, as Moobot was so pleased to say, if you are not following me on Twitch, please do follow me. If you are have not subscribed to me on YouTube, please do so. I love getting subscribers on YouTube, but of course, definitely follow. Even if you hate me, make sure that you follow the GOG.com Twitch channel, which is this channel right here. Just hit that little heart button, and you will see all sorts of fantastic things. There we go. Oh, and we got advanced to flight officer because we were doing so well. And I really thought there were bonus objectives in this level, but maybe not. Maybe I'm thinking of another one. Full of rebels trying to escape from their base on Hoth. Nightwolf, yeah, I have one with the throttle control. It's just in this game it only goes in 30% increments, I think, if you get it to work. So it's not smooth. It's not I don't even know what the word would be. It's not analog. It's digital, maybe. Doesn't quite work out. We captured a freighter full of rebels trying to escape from the planet Hoth. So yeah, there we go, guys. We've finished the first mission. The rebels. The recent Imperial attack on this base has driven their forces. And I just wanted to check something. Of these rebel prisoners should help us track more of them down. Fantastic. Okay. So pardon the interruption there. We finished the first mission, and that is enough for now, sir. Thank you very much. And we've already gone on 20 minutes. Have I really been blabbing that much, guys? This is ridiculous. We're gonna be here. I don't know if I introduced myself. Also, I was so excited to show my face. My name is Flaose. I am streaming for GOG.com. I love old games. I love Star Wars. So when Star Wars and old games combine, I love being here. And I've streamed, I think this is the fourth game in a week that I've streamed. And so, all in honor of Star Wars Day, and there's a Star Wars sale going on right now at GOG.com. Make sure you check it out. Alright, so we're on to our next mission. If we return to the concourse, we can see all sorts of things. We can start new battles if we want, we can change our battles, or we can continue our battle, which we're gonna do, and view our mission map. Three TIE fighters from Alpha, Beta, and Gamma squadrons I'm not sure, maybe you can change it, Nightwolf. I haven't tried in a long time.
Added concussion missiles to your TIE fighter.
Oh, nice. So we have missiles this time. We have a weak old TIE, but we have missiles, so we're ready to go.
All TIE fighters will destroy any incoming enemy.
Maybe this is the one where we deal with rebel fighters. A whole bunch of X-Wings. I think there's like 12 of them on you by the end there.
Come from the direction of Boy 18, where we stopped the smuggled rebel cargo. Our forces must survive until the Imperial class starts.
This kind of reminds me of one of those old missions in a Blizzard game, or I guess not an old mission, but a mission in one of those Blizzard games where you have to defend your base until the bad guys, or the good guys, arrive with reinforcements.
I am a special envoy of the Emperor.
Ooh, in this time of crisis,
political intrigue and open rebellion, the Emperor requires communication with his loyal forces. In the battles ahead, I will ensure that his wishes reach those like yourself who have pledged their fealty to him.
I've got my water.
Many opportunities to serve the Emperor, and will be rewarded for your efforts.
I feel so dainty drinking from a straw.
The rebel officers who are fleeing from Hoth in a stolen Imperial shuttle. We have forces standing by who will attempt to disable and capture this shuttle once you have located it.
All right, so this weird guy over here, this is your flight officer, then there's the dude standing in a hallway back here. If you talk to him, he gives you your secondary objectives. He works for the Emperor. If you get those secondary objectives done, you get way more points, and you're far more likely to enter the Emperor's inner circle, which is sweet. Maybe I'll give you guys a tease later on. So even though we're equipped with missiles, we can actually change to torpedoes, heavy bombs, or rockets, but those are not going to help us against rebel ships. And another great thing about this game is that if you get bored, you can hit Alt-T and it speeds up time 2 times, 4 times. Oh man, rebels and pirates working together.
Alpha Squadron, join the attack and engage the enemy.
So we'll see who's attacking me. Just the one guy. If you hit the Z button.
Stop all Y-wings from making torpedo
runs. If you hit the Y button, the Z button, you can actually see what the craft is up to. You get this right here. And I see I'm 33 seconds away or so. So maybe I'll get a missile lock. Shoot. And I'll break immediately because I'm just about in weapons range. So I'll crank up my lasers a little bit. No! I need the kill! Yes! I think I got that one. Nightwolf, right now I'm running on 60,000 cycles. Which is not ideal. A problem with this game, the way the game is programmed, is that the capital ships don't fire on you properly if you have it at max cycles or even high cycles. But if you turn it down too low, it doesn't run smoothly. So maybe I could boost the cycles a little bit because we're not really dealing with capital ships. Though I do want the base to defend itself. Yeah, out of all of this TIE Fighters, this is definitely the best. If you're new to the game, all the versions. If you buy from GOG.com, you get all three versions. But if you're new to the series, you may have difficulty with these old graphics. To me, they look beautiful. But I understand they're only 640 by 480. They're untextured. But the 1998 version changes the music to Redbook audio. Oh, good night, Inquisitor. Thank you so much for stopping by this late at night. And I know a lot of you are up super late, so if you do have to go, it's a Monday night. I understand that. But I'm glad that you were able to stop by. The 1998 has texture mapping and looks much better, but it doesn't have the dynamic audio, which is so important to this game, at least. Actually, when I was young, the computer I was running on had issues with the sound card. I don't know if it was probably an IRQ conflict that we never solved or something, but if sound effects were on, it would actually freeze the computer. Soundblaster sound effects froze the computer all the time, so I could only listen to the music. And so this game I played in silence. Sorry, there was no voices, there was no attacking ships, or like laser noises, there wasn't any sort of noise like that. There were no sound effects, I guess is what I should say. But there was the dynamic music, so I knew exactly what was happening. When rebels come in, you hear the rebel, a small part of the Rebel Alliance theme. When Imperials come in, you hear a small chunk of the Imperial theme, etc., etc. Oh, crap! And see, that's what happens when you hit a ship without shields. Totally not my fault. So we're coming back from battle. I could have died, but luckily this game auto-saves and you can restore your save. But in this case, I just died, and didn't die, I just came in bad shape, and it looks like I'll be alive. And so if you do not succeed, in my case it wasn't really my fault, I got crashed into by a suicidal X-Wing. But they give you hints if you ask any special instructions.
Watch your sensors carefully for the appearance.
And it'll tell you, so let's, Yeah, it's confusing because the 98 version of TIE Fighter is for Windows 95, so sometimes it's called TIE Fighter 95 when it's not. This is TIE Fighter 95. May the 4th be with you, Cortex Haxor. Oops, we're on 4x speed. We do not want that right now. I know, Heimdall. It's... Have you started streaming regularly? I'm pretty sure I'm subscribed or following you, but I haven't seen any online. But also, Twitch emails are not perfect, so... Nightwolf, I have the SciTech, that's S-A-I-T-E-K, X-52. It's a bit more than I need. This is more for really flight simulators, like real flight simulators or combat flight simulators when you're in F-16s and F-22s, that sort of thing. But I really like it. I grew up with an earlier version, the X... 45, I think, maybe was the number? And so I bought this while I was working at a technology store. So I got it for a little cheaper, but still, it's not cheap. And I know cheaper ones are okay for a lot of people. And you see here, there are torpedoes. They look like two torpedoes just hit each other. You can actually shoot down the torpedoes or missiles or any warhead with your own warhead, so like the torpedoes go way slower than my missiles. I could have locked on and shot them down with my missiles, or you can shoot them down with the lasers, but it is kind of hard to hit them sometimes. I'm going to crank up my cycles a bit. Now I'll just make sure that shuttle hasn't shown up yet. And it has not. Oh, they got him before I got there. Now in X-Wing Alliance and possibly in X-Wing versus TIE Fighter, they changed it so that the person who got the most hits on the craft got the kill. But in this game, I'm pretty sure it's whoever gets the last hit gets the kill. So you're all about stealing kills in this game. SciTech P880 gamepad. What do I have? I have a P... I can't even remember. Just give me a second here, guys. P990 is what I use for gamepad, along with my Xbox controller that plugs in. Both good. No, not the X52 Pro. Just the X52. There is a difference. The X52 Pro looks sweet, but I imagine it is much more expensive. Oh, I believe it. I believe it, Heimdall Plays. What else have you picked up lately for your streaming computer? Oops. Ah! Robbed! So you hear the last enemy was killed, and the music just tones down. It's suddenly super smooth, super relaxed, and then when an enemy ship's gonna enter, just listen for the cue, you'll hear it hit again. Or if the Imperials show up, you'll hear them, the Imperial... There we go. There we go. So we know Rebels are in the area. Bam! Turn around! But they're pretty far out of range, so the music tones down a little bit. But then it starts to... So this is the beauty of iMuse. I think of all the games that LucasArts released, iMuse was their own interactive music thing. It's their thing. This is the game that uses it the best, by far. And there are so many musical cues, you know exactly what's going on, even if you can't hear. Whew! Timed all plays, those are... No! So that music cue that just played means an Imperial craft just got destroyed. So that was one of my wingmen. And I'm gonna stay out of these guys' way. Because I don't want... happening what happened last time. Oh great, more Rebels enter the area. So even though I can't really see... Or I can't look at my log in the middle of the battle. Well, I can't... I can hit the L button and see exactly what happened. But if I hear what's going on with the music, then I don't have to look down. I can stay where I am and know more Rebel craft enter the area. Actually, that might... Yep. So this is Shuttle Scuts. This is my secondary objective. I got 3 minutes to rendezvous with him. Rendezvous. Oh, okay, maybe they are the same. The Pro is kind of the replacement, maybe, for the X-52 Nightwolf. That would make sense, I suppose. So I'm going to fly close to him so I can inspect him, and then I'm going to take down his shields. So he can be boarded. There we go. Might have been a mistake to do that one hit. But it looks like everybody else has been taken out, so we can go back to the platform. I love this MIDI soundtrack. I went on the GOG.com forum, there is a listing of different things you can do. There's this one post saying how you can get dramatically better music. And it was actually really simple. I was scared because the post looks pretty intimidating, but I was able to find really easily something that sounds fantastic in Windows, because usually Windows General MIDI does not sound good. I'm very unromantic, yay. Yes, so it's been disabled, and... Yeah. Okay. Nice Atomic Kiss. I love that game. Dude, I touched myself. I touched my face with my finger. Let me specify, hopefully. Not bad. Hello, Memories in 8-Bit. Good to see ya. So we got some Y-Wings on an attack vector. One for our gunboat, and the other after our platform. Nice Memories. You guys are going to destroy me tomorrow. Because, guys, something very exciting is happening tomorrow. If you haven't heard already, we are doing an Unreal Tournament. Unreal 2004. With all of... Not all of them, but a good chunk of the streamers are participating in that. And it's going to be tons of fun. We've gone all MLG Pro on it, pretending to be hardcore. And, during the raffle, which is going to happen at the top of the hour, thereabouts, I will be showing the fantastic trailer created by Matt and Outstar. I'm sure many of you have already seen it, but we gotta hype this thing to the kingdom come, because we are excited about it. Donus will be there, Alex will be there, Memories in 8-Bit will be there, Jordy, Outstar, Matt, Ryushin Sinshu. Actually, Matt's going to be not playing, but watching, commentating. He's gonna be our guy. Oh. Did the boarding craft? Oh, where are they? There we go. Okay. Seriously. And we're taking advantage of the Witcher 3 stream, which is happening right before it. So We're hoping for a huge crowd. We're hoping to have tons of fun. I know we're going to have tons of fun, but we're hoping that lots of people join us in that tons of fun. There we go. So we've survived the 9 minutes. We had to survive 9.5 minutes before a Star Destroyer showed up. And we're good to go. But we're going to wait until the shuttle is captured. So, these Corellian Corvettes, we are too weak to take them out. If you're feeling really brave, you can actually do it. You can exploit a weak spot right behind the engines, which they got rid of in X-Wing Alliance. You get engine wash damage. But you can exploit a weakness in these ones. If you sneak up, you can take them out. You can't take me to Padawan. I'm not even a learner. I'm an assassin, a Sith assassin, breaking the rule of two.
Alpha 1, return to the Hammer's hangar immediately.
I won't do what you tell me. So these guys are being attacked by some crazy... Our gunboats, our assault gunboats, but also our bombers are going to take bombing runs, or make bombing runs on them. And Gamma 3 thought he'd be great and just went on a suicide mission against them, which is crazy. Oh boy, TIE Fighters, no, why? Why would you attack Corellian Corvettes? Needless to say, the AI isn't as good in this game as in newer games. There are some questionable decisions made by your wingmen, but it's not the end of the world. So I'm gonna just wait. Oh, okay, Schutz doesn't even have to make it into space, or into hyperspace. But I've just cranked up the time a little bit. We're going to wait for the shuttle chutes to get out of here, which is happening in a minute. So I'll turn it to 4 times the speed.
Target destroyed.
Nice. So if you look at the timer, everything's going 4 times as fast. To try and dogfight in this would be insane, but right now it works. Yeah, that is one problem I also have with sticks, is that this one just doesn't have enough... Oh crap, I'm getting too close. It's got too much play, I feel. I love it, but it's got a lot of play in the stick. So now we're back at normal speed. If I were feeling brave, you know what, maybe I can even get this. I'll shoot a missile at it, maybe I'll have the last shot. Nah. There we go. Shaw Falk, that makes sense. Oh, I do not want to be targeting my Imperial Star Destroyer buddy boss. So here we go. They just destroyed all the Corvettes. And if we look at our bonus goals, it said the bonus goals were all completed. So 100% of Corellian Corvette Group Ubote was destroyed. And Shuttle Schutz was captured. So we're good to go. And those rebel officers will be taken to be interrogated. It's weird, my throttle has adjustable tension, but my stick does not. Alright, so let's return to base. Look at these beautiful graphics. Nice. And it gives you your rundown. You know, I got 3 warheads. My laser accuracy isn't so great, but we completed all primary, secondary, and bonus goals. We can learn what we accomplished. By the rebels. So what did we accomplish as the Empire?
We saved our outpost from destruction and destroyed many of the attacking enemy ships.
But this guy, since I'm doing secret missions from the Emperor, what did I accomplish?
The rebel officers you have located will prove useful to our cause. From them, we will learn the whereabouts of other rebel terrorists.
Nice. Sorry, what do you mean, Nightwolf? Both devices. Do you mean the keyboard and joystick, or the joystick and throttle, or the joystick and something else? Oh yeah, the expression changes. Let's just... So here's neutral, what do we accomplish?
You have defeated.
Oh, nothing. Okay, debrief me. Here we go, how many did we destroy? Watch his face. He smiles. How many did we lose? He gets all angry and stuff. Then he goes back to neutral. Metal Addict, I also like those. I also like them. So, one thing I want to show you is when you hit escape, you get to the Imperial database. So right now, this is basically the options menu. You can change your difficulty, you can change your flight resolution if you want to go down to 320 by 200. Maybe you have a really bad computer. Obviously not a problem here. This sleeve, we may get a chance to see later. But you can look at your record. So we can look at our medals. If you do training in the combat simulator, you fill these out. But Battle 1, you see all secondary goals completed in two missions of Battle 1. All bonus goals completed in one missions of Battle 1. And this will be the medal we get after completing the battle. So let's learn what we're doing.
We have traced the Mugari pirates' hyperjump path to a cargo loading area in the Tungra sector. Your first objective is to stop the cargo ferries from escaping with their contraband.
What is up, X5129119? Brofistio.
Then stop the transports and shuttles. Destroy anything that might be carrying weapons.
Oh yeah, I also have a throttle, joystick, Nightwolf, and I just don't usually use the throttle.
To engage the
The TIE bombers, I don't know. If needed. I'm not really using my devices to their full capacity. Nice toad relish. Another thing in this game is that you can call reinforcements. If you're feeling like you're in trouble,
be ready for any enemy.
You can call in reinforcements. It's going to hurt your final score, but it's going to save you. At least I think it hurts your final score.
Hyperjump path.
Oh, do they not have memories, or mysteries of the Sith on GOG Galaxy yet? Only use throttle and pulling. Full throttle. Nice. Brute. Alright, so we're playing as a TIE bomber now, and they recommend we use torpedoes, so usually they're recommending is what you choose. We get a cool little cutscene. Since we're launching from a Star Destroyer instead of a platform this time, we get this cutscene. Or a Star Dreadnought. Guys, I never get it right. I love Star Wars, but I cannot get that right.
Enemy targets dead ahead.
Thanks, boss. So if I hit the O key... Oh no, that's in newer versions. Never mind. In newer games, hitting the O key shows you your target. Your nearest target. So I think there's bonus goals for inspecting everybody. But since we probably don't want to replay this mission time and time again, might skip out on that. Beneath the steel sky, Wing Commander in Free Space. Yeah, I hear Free Space. I still haven't played it. I own it now, but I still haven't played it. It is very similar to TIE Fighter. It's a spiritual sequel, if there ever were one. Alright, so... we've got all sorts of things after us.
The attack on the Mugari pirates has begun.
Nice. But we'll see where my... Oh, they're attacking those guys. That's odd. If I check the map, I can actually see who am I? Who am I? TIE Fighter Alpha 1. Oh, okay. So I'm the flight leader, and I can choose who we're going to attack. And if I don't tell them, my wingmen have some autonomy, they will do what they think is best, which is not always the right choice, of course. But... yeah, Shafalka. R is the nearest fighter. Though I was looking for nearest just objective. And E will target your nearest enemy, someone who's actually targeting you and trying to kill you. Come on! So this guy's after the frigate Frogger. Rude! And hope that that guy does not shoot at me, because that would be very bad for my health. Oh, someone just crashed into me, I think. What just happened there? Yeah, TacCat, this game has aged fantastically. I love it. I honestly don't know what happened. Oh, great. So I've just been arrested. So we're going to see what happens when you restore. Thank you, TacCat. I'm pretty glad, happy how it came out. We've been arrested. Now, in X-Wing, there was no auto-restore. If you died or were captured, it was game over unless you'd backed it up yourself in DOS. Luckily, in this game, they have added an auto-restore and auto-backup. You can turn it off if you want to be hardcore, and you can also back up like that. So, there we go. Let's try this again and hope somebody doesn't run into us. I think it's because I hit zero throttle. Someone must have come up my rear. Man, I just can't avoid these today. Just destroyed me. Alright, let's give it one more go, guys, before the mid-stream raffle.
Enemy targets dead ahead.
Robot Lake, that's true. You know, I've never been able to get into Star Wars, Clone Wars.
Switch to torpedoes and fire at will.
I have this need to watch everything in order, but the first two seasons aren't very good. And I tried to watch Rebels, because apparently it was free on StarWars.com this weekend, or up until today. But, being in Canada, we were locked out, and even with a VPN spoofer, I wasn't able to get in. Attack at the old games, there are two versions, there are three versions of the game. Two of them are for DOS, and one is a remade version for Windows. The DOS version, which is, this is one of the two versions, this is the best version, as far as I'm concerned, you can still control with the mouse. So I'm controlling with the mouse now. It's not perfect because you have to keep going up, down when you're trying to move. But it works. Otherwise, you do need a mouse version, but generally need a mouse. Though, I believe on the GOG.com website, on the forum, whoa, no, my wingman! There is a patch, a user-made patch, that somehow overrides it. I'm not 100% sure on that one, though. Oh man, we lost an Imperial fighter. Yeah, this game was designed with a joystick in mind, really. So, I played it with a mouse when I was young, but it was really meant to play with a joystick. And apparently G-Pudding beat the game with a mouse. So it's not impossible. Impossible at all. There we go. Alright. So what we're going to do is take out the little guys first and then torpedo the big guys. And good night, X519119. Thank you so much for dropping by, and please make sure that you follow GOG.com if you do not already. Because we love new followers, and tomorrow we have a very special stream, guys. Two very special streams. First of all is the Witcher 3 stream. We're going to learn more about Witcher 3. But far more exciting, at least for me, is we will be having the UT2K4 tournament with the streamers. We're going to play an Unreal Tournament 2004. Fighting against each other, we're gonna have some serious pain going on. Ooh. Transport Don is right behind us. He's trying to take out the frigate Frogger. He is crazy. Now, if you saw there, I shot when it was lined up, but he turned at the last minute, so he avoided my shot. There we go. Goodbye. Thanks, Infesto. So if you find the HUD is in your way a lot in this game, you can actually turn it off with the period key, and now you can see really well, but you don't have, or I guess it's not the HUD, it's more like your frame, but you don't have your heads-up display, command display, which makes it more difficult. You don't know oh crap, no, not again, I just hit, oh, don't you dare steal my kill, there we go. Nightwolf, yeah. I'm glad the tweet came out with the picture. I was doing that last minute. I was already 10 minutes late when I started. Luckily, Donus was nice enough to actually keep on going. But it took way longer than I expected to do the makeup. A full 2 hours. And this was the result. Get out of my way! Ah.
Alpha 1, this is Alpha 2, using your target for attack.
So I'm gonna turn down my lasers a bit and take it. Oh, was uptime disabled? MoveOn just got an update, and I think they had to redo everything from scratch. I'm not sure. And looks like my uptime, the way time I'm saying this, is 5620. Thanks, Toad Relish. I appreciate it. So let's see. Actually, there's a... F2 is a warhead view, which is really fun. Boom! Yes! Exile Blizzard, yeah. It's a, are we won yet? Cargo ferries. Oh no!
This is Alpha 2, using your target for attack.
We are in trouble. Crap, they got away. Oh, that's embarrassing.
Target destroyed. Transmission received, using your target for attack.
Yes, it is Halloween makeup. Answer the question. Save since October. Oh, this is gonna be too close. Too close to call. I'm surprised that cargo ferry isn't defending itself. Come on! I'm gonna fire everything I got at it, but I think it's out of here. No! Ah, crap. Alright, looks like we gotta keep an eye on those cargo ferries. Alright, so we'll return to the Frigate Frogger, and you know what, guys? It's about that time. It is about time for a raffle. And you know what the raffle prize will be? Will be a $9.99 GOG.com gift code. So give me a minute or two to get it set up, and I'll let you know. Oh, I know, I love these MIDI tunes. I can't believe we failed this twice. Ugh.
Mission of failure.
Yeah, thanks. Thanks for the reminder, guys. Alright, so, let me get out of this window mode, and let me get everything set up in MooBot. Excuse me. We'll reset that raffle. Raffle is now open, and let's watch the video. So guys, make sure that you hit exclamation mark raffle to be entered in for the raffle to win a $9.99 gift card. Welcome, Logan. Yes, it is happening tomorrow, guys. Tomorrow. Do not miss out. I'm really excited for this. We are going to keep the raffle open for another minute or two. So, I'm going to turn off the text, but don't worry. The raffle's still open. We'll keep it open for a minute or two. Whew. Man. This is like, I'm going to indulge. There we go. Oof, oof. Scary. I haven't really had a chance to get a good look at the full thing because I finished just in time for the stream. Actually, 10 minutes late for the stream. But, you know what? Didn't have horns, but works out. Sorry. So with Move Out, we had a limited number of commands, and so we got rid of the... we had to get rid of the uptime command just for the Unreal Tournament thing. Unreal Tournament command, exclamation mark UT. But I'm sure once that is gone, once we have done this fantastic tournament tomorrow, it will be back again. So, I'll give it another 30 seconds or so, and we will call the raffle. So just so you know, my name is Flaose. I love old games. I love streaming. I love streaming for GOG.com, old games. oldgamesfordog.com. My English is not always the best, apparently. You can follow me on my Twitch channel, but you're more likely to find me here on this Twitch channel, gog.com's Twitch channel. So definitely follow this channel if you'd like to follow my channel, and also subscribe to me on YouTube, and you can learn all about what I love. You can see I review old games on my channel. I'm not the best, obviously, at doing it, but it's awesome. I love doing it. So please do subscribe, so when I do put out a new video every month or two, you'll be able to see it, because I love sharing it with the world. And Matt, I wish I could keep this on, but I don't think I can sleep with this. There's no way I will be allowed in the bedroom with this on. So I'm going to close the raffle up, guys. And we're going to draw ourselves a winner. And raffle's closed. Happy Star Wars Day, Pingy Dingy. The Star Wars releases happened a week ago in honor of this sale that's just started. So let's draw our winner. And congratulations, Insider. That is 1NSider. You are the winner of the $9.99 gift code from GOG.com. I will be sending that to you at the end of the stream. And, make sure you check in your other inbox for it, because it won't show up immediately. I'm sorry, Arshesny, I think you just missed it. So, congratulations, Insider. And, yes, thank you all for participating in the raffle. I've always wondered how many actually participate in the raffle, but I don't know of a function in Moobot to see it. So, guys, what time is it? We have another 40 minutes. We're going to destroy this game for the next 40 minutes or so. And, yeah, let's get her done. Oh, I better put back the game cam. There we go. You're welcome, Insider. It's really a gift from GOG.com. So, I don't know how much congrats I can take, but... Oh, you know what? I didn't grab my lightsaber. Just a second, guys. Yes! Gotta put this here.
Enemy targets dead ahead.
How can we get it in camera, though? That is not gonna last. Somehow not slicing through the roof. And of course I'm right in front of it. There we go. I am in the third level, I believe we're playing. Maybe the fourth level. I'm just getting all the innuendo tonight. So, you know what? The first thing we're going to destroy are these stupid cargo ferries. Because they're just waiting, and then they're going to try and escape.
Acknowledge Alpha 1, using your target for attack. The attack of the Bugari pirates has begun.
And thank you, Insider, for following GOG.com. I don't know if I mentioned that. We always appreciate when our winners are also followers. So far, we haven't felt the need to distinguish to force you to be a member or a follower of GOG.com to win the raffle. We just shame you a little bit in public. But, yeah, when you're already a follower, then we're good. Oh, guys. So now he's immediately heading for hyperspace. But luckily he's slow enough that my warheads take him right out. And it looks like it just takes four warheads, maybe even three. Oh, he's after me. Nope, four. And now he's shooting at me. Oh, boot discs and mem maker. Oh, I totally forgot about that. Thank you. Made my day. So now this dude is targeting me. That looks like we got away with it. And you know what? It might just be my cycles are too high, so now capital ships aren't firing. Oh, yeah, they're firing. Okay. All right, that should take care of the cargo ferries.
Target destroyed.
There we go. Sweet. So, now we can get this one. We'll finish this one toot sweet. As long as somebody doesn't escape into hyperspace. Use the fourth. Also, guys, if you like old games and you're not familiar with the GOG.com channel, I often stream on Friday old games. I have a show, I guess you could call it, that runs for 2 hours called the GOG Classics. And there I play generally old games or sometimes old school new games. And we just kind of learn together, or sometimes we'll learn them together, but we'll always play them together and have a great time. So make sure you check out the schedule. Exclamation mark schedule will get you there, and you can see what's coming up. Yeah, this is the third or fourth mission. I can't remember exactly. I've already forgotten. I think it's the fourth mission. Oh, yes, I love when they explode like that. So I know that this game is available on Steam, but honestly, Steam does not do very well with old games. They just slap them together. They don't care if the sound is, the music's working properly, if it's Redbook audio. If you run into trouble, everyone knows that Steam's support is terrible. But GOG.com, their support's pretty good, and even if they're not helping you out, the community is fantastic, and they will definitely help you. It's very rare that you run into a problem without, without a solution. Nightwolf, I love the classics. These days, I just don't find a lot of time to play video games. Usually, the games I'm playing, I'm preparing for the stream with. Though, a fantastic new game that I was playing pretty recently that plays like an old game is Rogue Legacy. You guys, if you like platformers, if you like roguish games, definitely check it out. Yeah, the GOG.com is fantastic about getting the games to work, unlike the other guys.
This is Gamma 1, target destroyed.
And so I like Steam. There are some members of, or some streamers that are completely against that, and I understand that. But for me, I usually buy my new games on Steam. Not that I buy new games these days either. But I have a decent Steam library, and I'm okay with that. But for old games, or things that are available on GOG.com and not anywhere else, always gonna go GOG.com because I know it's gonna work, and I know if I run into troubles, real people are gonna help me. So, and I'm not saying that because I'm paid, because I'm not paid to do this. And I'm not doing it because I'm afraid to bite the hand that feeds me either. I'm just, because GOG.com is good, guys. And it sounds, you can hear there's a MIDI note that's stuck playing. That is a problem with Windows, apparently. And usually if it plays again, it goes away. But what we're going to do is actually quit and restart, because that's going to get very annoying very fast. Oh, and we got promoted to Lieutenant. And we missed out on the bonus goals, which I think was inspect everything before destroying it.
We attacked when both parties to the weapons deal were still in the area.
Good night, EA. Thank you so much for stopping by. And have a great night.
All of the Mugari and Rebel craft.
So, before we turn the briefing, oh, yes, the note got hit. Right when I was about to quit, got hit. Hit it, don't quit it.
Outpost D-34,
and it got fixed.
The rebels and the Mugari are looting it for arms and equipment.
So, we go and destroy that base there, guys, and the rebels sneak up and capture our station. Okay, so I guess that was mission 3 we're on. We are now on mission 4.
Thai starfighters will provide cover for this operation. These groups will
I need to wash that water bottle out.
With the station's equipment.
Yes, guys, if you're curious about the schedule, make sure you just click the link that Mubot put up there.
D-34 has been there. Captured. The rebels and the Mugari are...
So let's see what our bonus mission objectives are.
Is concerned by the rebels' capture of outpost D-34. The most disturbing element is that they seem to know exactly how to time their attacks when Imperial forces are engaged in another sector. Be alert for clues and opportunities to inspect or capture any rebel craft leaving the outpost
okay.
When we recapture it.
Alright, so we are flying a TIE Interceptor this time. They like to switch things up right at the beginning. TIE Interceptor has 4 lasers. And we're launching from a capital ship, so we get to see the sweet cutscene. Still looks pretty good, even after 20 years. But you gotta evade immediately. So, if your cycles aren't high enough, these things are deadly. We're getting some chop. Sorry, I'm just gonna make sure my cycles are up higher. Normally the game comes with max cycles. The only reason I've turned it down is so capital ships act properly, but it's being a bit, it's being a bit moody. Temperamental, I guess, is a better word. Oh, yes, the TIE, first time you're flying the TIE Defender, you just absolutely destroy. There is no competition. You just learn how powerful that baby is. So these escort shuttles, I hate these things, because they have turbo lasers on the back. So if it targets you, you're in huge trouble. Most shuttles you can sneak up behind and destroy. But you can actually target the laser turret itself. We're going to try that. And get a lock, get a lock. Boom. Oh, okay, well that takes care of the problem. But if you've targeted it, you can take it out so it's not a threat, and then you can just stay behind it and destroy it. So I'll wait for him to turn around. Prep! And... shoot! My missiles didn't do their job! So now I have a turbo laser firing at me. Alright, good night, Nightwolf. Thank you so much for stopping by. I appreciate it. And once again, happy Liberation Day. Oh, man. Oh, I can't believe I'm still alive. So right now I am in big trouble, guys. Huge trouble. I'm going to just, I probably shouldn't have done that. My wingmen are dead. So, I'm just going to fly around in circles, get them out of range. Flaose. We'll see if we can take out these. The turbo. Oh, great. Our turbo lasers are targeting me! Didn't take it out. The power of the dark side. And I still have a missile, so maybe I'll fire it at this guy. Hopefully it'll take him out, because I can't deal with him right now. There we go. Now I don't even know what my laser recharge level is. I'm in trouble. Luckily the other TIE interceptors didn't get themselves killed like my buddies did. Oh, come on. I know I'm in range, but I'm having a hard time finding the right place to shoot. Out here farther. Oh, wrong button! And I just accidentally hit the C button, which turns on the flight data recorder. And unlike X-Wings, which links the opposite lasers, this links the top and bottom lasers to get, like, I fire two top, two bottom instead of opposite across. If you hit the X button, you can change how many lasers you fire at once, but of course there's a cooldown period, so if you have it all the way off, we'll see what happens. All the way off is good for trying to take out torpedoes, but they are pretty hard to hit. And really, the frigate's a tough cookie. It'll be okay. I hope he doesn't break up, or I am in trouble. And one more should do it. Oh, I missed. Oh, wow. Y-wings are sweet. Absolutely slow and terrible to fly, but quite strong. Alright, looks like they're about to take out the platform. Or not take it out, recapture it. Oh shoot, totally forgot. So what I'm going to do is do a quick flyby of the gopher. I don't think I'll be able to capture it, but, you know. We might get a bonus objective for just checking it out before it escapes into hyperspace. Oh. Never mind. It's my secondary objective. This is the escaping craft I need to check out. Hopefully he doesn't target me. In this game, they generally don't target you unless you attack them first. Which is a big difference than other games in the series, newer games in the series.
Begin capture
there we go.
Secondary mission objectives completed. We will locate the rebels' cache or stolen equipment. Transport Omega will disable and capture this transport.
I don't think Omega's gonna reach it in time. So we're gonna miss out on that bonus objective, but fly, you fools, fly! Yeah, they're too far out. So I'll just speed up time a little bit and return to the frigate. I think that's what I was told to do. It doesn't really matter where you go. Yeah, no, there's no shields. Sometimes they have shields, I think. There's modified interceptors that do have shields. Maybe in newer games, but, and so, since I accidentally hit the C button, we could watch the flight recorder film, but it's only a minute. Bam! Nice. Returning from battle with victory for the Emperor! Entrance to the Secret Order of the Emperor.
Prepare to join the Secret Order of the Emperor.
Just a little guy. So it starts off with a small tattoo, but it gets huge. We've been advanced to captain. We got that little tattoo because of our score. Spectrum Legacy, I think TIE Fighter is my favorite, and maybe it's just because I grew up with this game. X-Wing Alliance, close second. I don't really like X-Wing versus TIE Fighter. It's not a bad game, but it's really a multiplayer game. The Defender of the Empire adds a little something to it for sure, like a good campaign, but it's just not the same as a story-driven game like this one or X-Wing Alliance. And X-Wing's just, it's a little old for me. Yeah. I have a hard time with the 320 by 200 resolution because I grew up with TIE Fighter, or I had it before I had X-Wing, so I don't know. Anyway, so we are the first initiate of the Secret Order of the Empire. We get all sorts of sweet tattoos as we continue doing missions for the Emperor. So, let's continue on. So we missed out on that one.
Despite
but hey.
An intense battle, our forces prevailed in recapturing outpost D-34.
Yeah, Hooken, that's correct.
The rebellion's plan to loot and pillage
or Hooken.
Property has been
The TIE Defender is just basically the best. More lasers, two ion cannons, or ion turrets? I don't even know what to call it. Alright, have a great night, Pet Mice. Thank you for stopping by. What did I accomplish?
Excellent. You have helped us locate the equipment the rebels looted from outpost D-34.
There's also a weird ship, the missile boat, which comes with the expansion. So I think starting at Battle 11, which was the second expansion to TIE Fighter, which comes with TIE Fighter CD. And it plays completely differently. You just have one small laser and a whole bunch of, I guess, missile racks, you'd call it, on your ship. And so you're meant to use missiles, which is a totally different way of playing. And you also have something called the slams, which is a huge acceleration booster that you use temporarily. It has beam weapons, so you can freeze people in places. It gets crazy. The missile boat's a totally different craft to fly. You're very welcome, Pet Mice. I love this game, so I was happy to stream it.
Assume the cruiser has a strong force of A-Wing, X-Wing, and B-Wing starfighters. Our attack will proceed in waves.
You will fly. So once again, we're flying a new ship. The gunboats.
Your primary task is to destroy the starfighter defense that the cruiser will send into battle. Once the starfighter defense has been eliminated, assist the second wave in their attack.
Seriously, Carby.
Into the battle in 5 minutes. They will escort transports carrying torpedoes. The supply containers need to be destroyed to prevent the cruiser from getting resupplied.
So this first one, we're getting rid of the cruiser's defenses, and we'll just slowly be whittling it down, and of course, we'll come to the climax of destroying it, hopefully in the next mission, if not, and then in two missions. So we'll try and get this done quick, because we want to get it done in about half an hour, and I want to be able to show you the whole battle. To see if they may be carrying Imperial. And just wet your whistle, because guys, this game is fantastic. If you have never played it, I totally recommend it. There are three versions included at GOG.com. The GOG.com version, it's only $9.99 base price, and it's also in a bundle with other fantastic Star Wars games for May the 4th. And you can pick that up for up to, I believe it's, I don't want to say the wrong thing now. I think it's 77% off. It might be 60% off. There are two different bundles, and they have different savings amounts, but very good. Lawfear, yeah, it's, I'm glad it was impactful. I've always liked these cutscenes and this music. Though it's weird how the gunboat is racked like this, but you can't actually put up your wings. Oh, and we finally, guys, have a hyperdrive.
The cruiser has launched starfighters. Let's take them out.
And I also have ion cannons, which we probably will get a chance to play with in a minute.
Group new, engaging A-wings. Group new, engaging X-wings.
Wait, who am I? Tau. A-wings. So I feel like that transport is something we want to take out. Oh, what does he drop? Is he a mine layer? So in this game, guys, there are mines. We'll see what he drops off in 4 minutes. 4 seconds, I mean. I do believe he's dropping off mines. Yep. Which are very annoying. Luckily, we have shields now. So I'm gonna take him out before he lays all his mines. Oh crap. There we go. So there are different kinds of mines. This one is right there. Let me see my shields are down. There we go. And you can actually balance your shields hitting the S button. Forward, back, balanced. And I'm getting attacked by A-wings. This might not be a successful run. Shoot. Oh, boy. Oh, yeah. No. Okay, so that was a terrible idea to go after that thing. Yeah, Heimdall, I'm not sure why Starfighter was mixed in there. Are you in need of any assistance? Yes. Very many. Very much so. Alright, let's try this again. Maybe he has some hints for me.
Dogfight outside the range of the cruiser's lasers. Use your missiles sparingly and against the most difficult targets, the A-wings. Before firing, make sure you have a full missile lock, signified by a red gun sight.
Yeah, that was not too successful. Now you can skip these cutscenes, but I really like them, so. Crash Cat, I'm pretty good. That's why they heal me. They don't want me to be dispensable. I'm good enough to be worth saving. So this time, I am going to charge up my shields immediately. Oh, we're supposed to take out the B-Wings. Haha, oops. So, B-Wings. There we go. B-Wing gold. Now the B-Wings are actually pretty strong, so they are a danger, and what you can do is actually disable them, and so you can take them out a little later. Disabling's a little quicker than destroying outright. So once their shield is down, you can disable them, and then they're easy pickings. Of course, I did that and got my kill stolen, so maybe I won't do that again. Oh, I think I just accidentally destroyed one of my buddy's missiles that was heading for the B-Wing. Yeah, I think even if I am a clone, if we're going with that idea of still using clones so many years later, clones take a while to grow. Oh, come on. There we go. Oh, so we got these jerk mine layers. And maybe I'll send my guys to take out. No, guys, no, no! Oh. So I wanted to inspect those before they destroyed them, but whatever. Now, where I have my camera, I can't actually see my shield, so it's easy to lose track of where my weapons are. Oh, they're out of clones. Okay. That's good to know. Not again! Oh, jeez. So right now I have a full flight of A-Wings after me, which is not conducive to good health. So I just hit the Shift E key, and that sent my wingman to help me. So hopefully he'll start taking out some of these bad guys that are after me. Oh shoot, I'm in trouble. Incoming missile. So I got very lucky there. And was able to dodge the missile, I think. If you're quick, you're able to dodge. But you have to be very quick. How did this happen? How did I get so many guys after me so quickly? Alright, well there goes my wingman. So I'm gonna use a new strategy, I guess. Because I don't even know how many A-Wings are after me. But too many is probably the right answer. Nice, Lego TIE Fighter picks. I love it. Shoot! Oh, that was close. It just barely broke the missile lock. So hopefully some of these guys peel off and attack the gunboats that are not me. Right now I'm just trying to survive. Sheesh. Wow. That was not successful at all. What were your instructions again?
Dogfight outside the range.
Alright. I don't remember ever having this much trouble in this mission. I'm gonna try it again. If it doesn't work, we're dropping down to easy, guys. Because we must move on. There was somebody in the GOG.com forum talking about how they had finished this game on hard and completed all the objectives. I can't even imagine doing everything. Yeah, seriously, shuffle. Oh, he just dodged it. Probably will never catch up. So right now I got the B-Wings after me, but... I don't know, unfortunately, I can't be here for much more than a half hour. Oh man. Alright. So I'm gonna attack the A-Wings. Maybe if we take out these A-Wings... I know, it seems almost a waste time, Dahl, to get all dressed up like this and then quit so quickly after, but unfortunately... That's the way it's probably gonna be. On. So I'm just gonna send my my wingman is gonna destroy the B-Wings and I'm gonna destroy everything else, hopefully. That's my plan at least. Because hopefully if I destroy the X-Wings and A-Wings before the other A-Wings come out, I'll have somebody that's actually killing those other A-Wings. So all five of them aren't attacking me at once. And sorry guys, if you're talking in chat, I am very concentrated right now on what is going on around here. Trying not to die again.
Transmission received. Using your target for attack.
Now if I remember right, the next mission is one of my least favorite missions at the beginning because you're just taking on mines. It's just, I don't know. The mines just aren't very fun to deal with. Okay, let's see. Okay. Now we'll turn our attention to the B-Wings. Actually, I'm gonna take this guy out. If I can. Shoot. So I'm gonna weaken his shields because I'm waiting for my lasers to charge up. I'm weakening with the ion cannons. Now I'll take him out. Oh man, I can't even imagine this game in Oculus Rift. Oof. VR is a great idea. I probably wet myself. Be too intense. Time are we at? Oh good. Backup has arrived. Five X-Wings. I'm out of here. And I always liked how the music ramped down like that. Whew, we did it. So, those X-Wings go on for a long time. Too much work. What did we accomplish, guys?
Destroyed the cruiser's starfighter defense.
Nice.
Good work. This will allow our forces to destroy the cruiser.
That is enough for now, sir. Oh man. Just as the Emperor suspected, old VR just didn't work. Were found among the rebel supplies. I'm glad that it's actually working for real now with Oculus Rift. It's exciting. Scary, but exciting at the same time. Sophisticated Imperial high-tech equipment to the enemy. This is treason. Thank you, Told Relish. Alright, guys.
Our last attack rendered the rebel cruiser.
This is it.
Vulnerable for a direct attack using torpedoes. Transports Sigma and Omega have been
synthesized trumpets. The rebel cruiser.
Assault gunboat groups Tau and Nu will provide close escort for the attacking transports. Rebel starfighter threat is low.
All right, guys, it looks like,
however, some fighters may have survived.
This is probably going to be the last mission we're playing tonight, and I'm really sorry about that. But it's already 6 o'clock, where I am. Sorry, it's already at the hour.
Our last attack rendered the rebel cruiser Lulsa.
And I might actually quit for a second.
The Imperial attack on the Rebel cruiser will certainly succeed.
It's impenetrable. Seriously, Heimdall.
Probably cause its commander and crew to try to abandon ship. Be prepared to track down its commander and disable his escaping craft. Any other fleeing ships should be destroyed.
Destroyed. Okay, so we have that annoying note playing right now. And so I'm just going to go drop to DOS for... Well, not actually DOS. I'm going to drop out. And, oh, I forgot. Drop right back in. Yeah, it's not the time. Like, it's not that it's too late to be streaming. It's just the fact that I have other things I need to do tonight. Unfortunately. I don't know. I'll leave it up to you guys. What do you want to do? Because, you know, I'm actually... What time is it? You know what? I am free for another hour. If you guys want to keep going, let's go for it. Hacker, there was a note hanging. The General MIDI, I have General MIDI music going on right now, and Windows doesn't play very nice with MIDI, and there was a hanging note. And the only way to get rid of it is either it plays, and that'll usually reset it, but... often it will just hang forever, and so the best way to do it is to quit. I don't know, Crash Cat, maybe you guys are sick of this already. But I did... I've been excited for this for a long time, so I feel like I can't... I don't want to give up so much. So quickly. So I know a lot of you in Europe right now, that's another thing. It's 2 o'clock in the morning, guys, for many of you. And it's... Oh, I'm getting a phone call. Shoot. That sounds important. Oh well. Alright, I'll continue on for a while, guys. It's just Monday, and you know. What are my objectives again? Wonder who just called. And where are these missiles going? Oh, the mines. Oh, mines are the worst. Nah, we'll see if they leave a voicemail. If they call back, I'm gonna pause and turn off the microphone. And, So these mines are horrendous. These ones are okay, actually. But these mines... No, not these. Sorry, there is another set of mines that is out here that actually shoot missiles at you every time they're destroyed. They're very annoying. And that guy's attacking me. Are you crazy, man? What's an aluminum falcon? I just about had a crash there. I just about crashed right into a container. That would have been bad. So what I should have packed along were rockets, so I could have attacked the Mon Calamari cruiser directly. Have to be mindful of my surroundings. Oh man. Yeah, there's definitely a way to get multiplayer working with X-Wing versus TIE Fighter. It might not be easy. I like how there's one of everything just still around. Yeah, we got a Y-Wing, we got a B-Wing, we got an X-Wing. That's it, everyone else is dead. Alright, good night, Hatniks. Thank you so much for stopping by. Have a great night. Trying to get a hard lock, but it's tough when you're this close. Oh, he survived that. No way. And my deflector shields are damaged because I got too slow. And let's just check out our damage. Ooh, 36 seconds without shields. This is not going to be good. I'm just going to be flying around, answering texts. I'm flying while texting. I know this is terrible. And I'm going to see who left me the voicemail. And I'm just waiting for my thing to start up. This looks ridiculous. Oh great, now I have a capital ship targeting me. Oh, yeah. Okay, I need to make a call. I should have made it before I started streaming, but, okay, all these mines are insane, but, whoa, what? Oh, crap. My engines just failed. I'm toast. Oh, that's good. So we're needing medical assistance. I'm in need of making a phone call, guys. So, I'm gonna take a short break. So, if you'll pardon me for a few seconds, and by seconds I mean minutes, let me just, oops, that's the wrong button. Add some text here. And, sure. Oops. Flaose will return momentarily. There we go, looks great. Okay, yeah, you guys want to see the trailer again? Sure, I will play... I'll play some more. I'll play a trailer and then I'm gonna make the call. So let me just get rid of the music here. And I'll be back in a couple minutes. All right, everybody, thank you so much for your patience. Oops, that was not the button I meant to push. There we go. Let's see, how many people do we still have watching here? Ooh, still over 100, not bad. Okay. So, I messed something up with work, and I needed to make that call. So, let's continue where we left off. And see if we can't do some damage. Oh good, I remembered to turn my microphone back on this time. Yesterday I was streaming with Saturday, I forgot to turn my microphone on. It was rather embarrassing. Oh guys, I'm so sorry about that. There we go. I remembered the microphone, forgot to switch the game screen. Good night, Dark Daedalus. Thank you so much. It's always something, isn't it? So what I'm actually going to do is crank my shields. Because these guys will die in one hit. But I don't know where I was gonna go with that. They'll die in one hit, so I don't need. Oh great. The problem is when you destroy those ones, they shoot a missile out. But if you're close enough, they won't necessarily hurt you. Thanks, Spectrum Legacy. And have a good night, too. As well. Yodi as well. Have a great night. Not great. How was my shields? Doing okay. One good thing to know, guys, is that... Oh, shoot. Oh, wow, I completely forgot what I was going to say. I completely blanked there. I apologize. I have no idea where I was going with that. There was a good thing I was going to tell you about, but I don't remember what it was. Yeah, so this mission isn't impossible by any means. It's just the mines are really annoying because they're always shooting at you. And I also have a ship firing at me. It looks like I have three ships on me. I don't know, my wingman might be dead. No, I don't know what my wingman was doing. What am I doing? I'm trying to take on an A-wing while I'm super slow. Had to turn down my shields back to normal. Turn down my laser recharge a bit. And now we're back in action. And so he's still faster than me, but he's not nearly... The distance isn't as much as it was before. Painful. I'm sure it's even worse to watch. There we go. One more hit. One more solid hit. I'll take him out for good. There we go. Holy. And we've almost got our shields up full. My wingman is just not... Whoa! Oh, great. Yeah, so that just hit me. If I were in a TIE fighter, that would have killed me right there. Yeah, I feel like they would probably dumb this down a lot if they were to make it again. Or not dumb it down, but make it a lot easier. One thing that would be good, though, is in-level saves. Because sometimes you'll, like... You'll spend a good half hour trying to finish a level, and you'll die right at the very end, and you gotta start all over again. But I mean, people have been calling for those forever, and they still haven't come. Target destroyed. Oh, and I took out that guy's engines. Good, good, good. It sounds like there is a note hanging again. It's just something to get used to. There we go. So now, let's take on some mines. Oh boy. Oh man, my joystick. There we go. Target
destroyed. Incoming missile.
There we go. And I got some X-Wings after me. Again. Oh, and he ran into me. Was that my... Alright, so now I'm in big trouble, I think. I may have four X-Wings after me. I don't know if I can survive that. Hoken, I am using the Cytec X52 joystick. Oh, hello. Oh, and I'm flying like an idiot with my shields up all the way. So I was super slow, sitting duck, and now I can actually match this guy's speed and possibly take him out. Yeah, the dead zone's at zero. Like, I'm at the lowest dead zone possible with my stick. So I'm not sure. I don't know if there's something else I can do. Because I don't want to play this mission again. Oh, wow, okay. We are in trouble now. Yeah, it's kind of hard to get your bearings in space so that everything feels right. Okay, it looks like we might be doing okay now. One of the X-Wings is gone, at least. Or, I mean, the wingmen seem to have taken out one of the X-Wings. And, okay. I may have to call in reinforcements because I think everybody is dead. Is this guy not toast? Die, die, die! I guess it doesn't help that I'm not using fully charged turbo lasers. There we go. Oh boy. So I'm gonna call in the reinforcements. That's shift R. Oh, can I not call in reinforcements? Uh-oh. So we may be in some serious trouble. Again. Because I may have to take out a Mon Calamari cruiser on my own, which is not the way it's supposed to work. I don't know what's going on here. So what I'm gonna do... is get as far away as possible. I'm gonna crank up the time and just sit here for a bit. Yeah, it's a Mon Calamari light cruiser. There we go, now we're full. I'll turn the time back to normal. So So the cruiser is completely on its own. All my friends are dead. And while this isn't impossible, it's pretty hard for me to be successful. At least I have some space bombs. I have a small chance of taking him out. Very small chance. And once again, turbo lasers are targeting me. Actually, oh man. Now I got nervous and touched my upper lip. When you're a friend of Flaose, you end up dead. Seriously, guys. Okay, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna launch my space bombs. And then I'm gonna try and disable the ship. And then just kind of take it out while it's a sitting duck. I don't know if this is going to work, guys. We're going to try this, though. Because apparently I don't have any reinforcements. I don't have anything. No help is coming. So we'll see what happens. There are a couple mines protecting it. Oh, yep, okay, okay. This is good. This is good. Good thing I brought space bombs along. Holy cow. Shuttle Daris was not to say. Oh, I destroyed the shuttle in the explosion. So we're not going to pass our secondary objectives here.
Rebel transports are evacuating the Los.
And you know what? Honestly, I've almost had enough of this level. Because, I mean, look at these mines. This is insane. You know what? Forget it. We're out of here. We're going to hyperspace. Right through some mines. We're done. Battle finished. Well, that wasn't... It's the only way. Oh, man, Hacker, I would... If I were playing this on my own, I would have restarted the mission after that. I am a bit of a perfectionist, at least when it comes to the secondary goals. Ooh.
With an offer for the rebellion.
We have little reason to trust you, Admiral Harkov.
Admiral Harkov, no!
To hear your offer.
You can't betray the Empire. I'll hunt you down and destroy you.
My friend is willing to join the Rebel Alliance. For a price.
Very interesting, Admiral. We have great need for officers of your caliber. Here is what I propose.
We have completed a battle for the Empire. Great success. Alright, we received a medal! 3 of 10 bonus goals, 1 of 3 secondary goals. It was not a very successful mission in that regard. And, we lost the entire attacking wave.
You helped to destroy the light.
Helped? I destroyed it!
This is a major achievement in our fight against the rebellion in this sector.
I wonder how many points I received for destroying that Calamari cruiser. I did okay. Destroyed some space objects.
Watch carefully for any craft that are fleeing the Lulzla.
Yeah. Okay. So, that's the end of Battle 1. When you finish a battle, once again you are returned to the concourse.